This is the inside story of digestion. Down, down, down. And here to tell you about it is the one and only Slim Goodbody.
Bodies come in different shapes and sizes. Some people are fat, some people lean. Some of the people are right in between. Some people have zip, others get beat. But you can be a winner if you watch what you eat. Sing along with me. Food is the fuel that'll keep us alive. Food is the fuel that'll give us a drive. Food is the fuel that'll keep us on the go. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. Food is the fuel of life. It gives your body the energy it needs to live and grow. The food coming into your mouth has a long and interesting trip to make. Once you swallow it, it moves through such exciting places as your esophagus, your stomach, the small intestine, and the large intestine. Along the way, saliva from glands in your mouth and digestive juices from your liver and pancreas get poured over it.
When you were a baby, your body was smaller. Now you've grown bigger.
And very much taller. Because your body takes the food you chew and changes some of it into you. It's true. Sing along. Food is the fuel that'll keep us alive. Food is the fuel that'll give us a drive. Food is the fuel that'll keep us on the go. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. Delicious. Let's go. Food must be changed physically and chemically before your body can make use of it. The process of changing food is called digestion. Everybody say digestion. Good. Now, physically, food must be broken into small enough pieces to be carried by your blood and absorbed by your cells. Chemically, food must be divided into its separate nutrients in such a way that your body can make use of them. Now, this is no simple matter. But fortunately, your body has a system, the perfect system, the digestive system, which, helped along by the heart and circulatory system, delivers the digested food to every cell in your body. Do you know what's the first important stop food makes when it enters your body? That's right, your mouth. Everybody has two sets of teeth, it's been shown. One when you're younger and one when you've grown. Now before you swallow any food, your teeth make sure that it's well chewed. Teeth, yeah, I sure do need you. Teeth, yeah, I need you to chew. Teeth, no, I don't wanna lose you, so I'll keep you clean and not misuse you. The teeth in front are called incisors and canines. Then come the bicuspids and the molars up behind. Your front teeth tear, the back teeth chew. They all work together and there are 32. Teeth, yeah, I sure do need you. Teeth, yeah, I need you to chew. Teeth, no, I don't wanna lose you, so I'll keep you clean and not misuse you. Visit the dentist, 'cause that's the boss, who will show you how to brush and use dental floss. Go twice a year so your teeth will stay strong. Walk into the office and sing out this song. Teeth, yeah, I sure do need you. Teeth, yeah, I need you to chew. Teeth, no, I don't wanna lose you, so I'll keep you clean and not misuse you. You know, your mouth helps in another important way. Glands pour saliva onto the food, which makes it moist and easy to swallow. This starts the process of digestion. Remember to chew your food well before you swallow. The trip the food takes is through a single long tube, which is about 11 meters long. Now, this tube keeps changing size, shape, and function. It begins as the narrow esophagus, broadens out into the stomach, thins down into the small intestine, and widens once again into the large intestine. This tube is a name. It's called the alimentary canal. It's also called the gastrointestinal tract, and it's lined with muscles which push the food along. The liver plays an important role here, too. It produces a digestive juice called bile, which pours into the small intestine and helps break the food down chemically. It takes the food anywhere from 12 to 24 hours to make the journey.
Hey, Slim, what happens to the food after you eat it?
Well, it goes down, 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 down. When you swallow the food, it moves along a tube called the esophagus. Everybody say esophagus!
Esophagus!
The esophagus is your food tube that goes from the throat to the stomach. Say food tube!
Food tube!
That's very good. Now, muscles push the food along the esophagus.
What happens then?
It goes down, 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 the esophagus, down, down, down. Next, the food will drop into your stomach, kerplop.
Plop.
Now, when the food drops into the stomach, the muscles begin to churn it up. They mix it with an acid which changes the food from a solid into a liquid. Well, teeth, what should we ask the kids to do now?
Stomach churn.
Good. Down, 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 down into the stomach. Kerplop, down, down, down. When the food leaves the stomach in the form of a thick liquid, it moves into your long, small intestine.
How long is it?
Well, it's about 6 meters long. It's very curvy and strong. Now, as the food flows through, some of it passes through the walls of the intestine, gets picked up by the blood, and carried to your cells. Circle with your finger, everybody. Okay?
Just like.
Round and around 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 and around.
What happens now, Slim?
Well, some of the food passes on into the large intestine. Now, basically, two things happen to food. What's good stays with you, and the rest you flush through. Now, right now, I want everybody to do something with me. Take your favorite piece of food out of the air. Look at that food. Smell that food. Say, I love you, food.
I love you, food.
Yes, put it into your mouth. Chew it up.
Chew it well.
Right. Now, I want you to swallow it. Put both hands here. And one more time with feeling.
Let's go.
Down, 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 down. Down, down. Oh, one more time, teeth. Down, 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 down. Did you know there was once a man who actually saw with his own eyes how food was digested in another person? Dr. Beaumont was an army surgeon on the Western frontier. His patient, Alexis St. Martin, had a permanent hole in his stomach.
How lucky I was that the bullet wound never fully healed. Poor Alexis. For years, he's worried that things would fall out through that hole. But a flap of his skin and a bandage keeps it all in. I want him to rest longer so his food will digest. Here's what I've had in his stomach for an hour now. A small and large piece of cabbage and a small and large piece of meat. I think I'll see how they're doing. There. The cabbage pieces are gone, and the small piece of meat is almost gone. Now, this tells me that some foods, like cabbage, go down faster than others, like this meat. Also, the small piece of meat was digested faster than the larger piece, which means it's better to chew your food well before swallowing. Now, let's see how it goes with these.
I'm not hungry.
Oh, no.
You are supposed to be done with this.
Alexis.
Listen, Beaumont, I'm sick and tired of this. For years, you've been poking around in my stomach.
Alexis, I just found out that if you chew your food into smaller pieces, it would help your digestion.
I don't care.
Well, you should care. Remember, smaller pieces. And don't get so excited when you're
eating.
What good is any of this doing me?
We're learning a great deal, and relax, you'll upset your stomach.
You're learning a lot. All I've got is this hole.
Calm down, Alexis, or you know what'll happen. Yes, I can see already. Too much acid and gas.
Really? Well, whatever it is, can't be any worse for me than this hole.
Now, please, Alexis, don't get so excited. Relax, or else. Just as I thought.
In the small intestines, the final work of digestion is done. The small intestines are about 6 meters long. Food has been broken down physically and chemically, and it now can be absorbed into your body. So it passes through the walls of the intestine and into the capillaries. From there, it is carried to each and every one of your cells, where it will provide them with the nutrients they need. Different foods do different things for your body. Carbohydrates is a word that sure sounds weird. It's just sugars and starches, nothing to be feared. Found in vegetables, fruit, cereals, and macaroni, it's our major source of energy. Rum, rum, rum. Food is the fuel that'll keep us alive. Food is the fuel that'll give us a drive. Food is the fuel that'll keep us on the go. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. Proteins are used to build your body tissue. Eat enough, you look so good, everyone will wanna kiss you. Found in meat, chickens, fish, milk, cheese, eggs, and more, like red beans and rice, which you find at your store. Love your food. Food is the fuel that'll keep us alive. Food is the fuel that'll give us a drive. Food is the fuel that'll keep us on the go. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. Fats are found in milk, butter, cream, and cheese. You eat them in the winter and you won't have to freeze. They're good for heat and energy long after you've begun. But eat too much and you'll weigh your ton. Sing along! Food is the fuel that'll keep us alive. Food is the fuel that'll give us a drive. Food is the fuel that'll keep us on the go. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. A list of nutrients must include vitamins and minerals we get from food. They help us use food's energy and make sure our bodies run properly. Oh, love your food now. Food is the fuel that'll keep us alive. Food is the fuel that'll give us a drive. Food is the fuel that'll keep us on the go. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. You gotta eat right if you wanna grow. Your body is truly amazing, but it's up to you to take good care of it. A balanced diet is essential to health. Remember, there's no such thing as a single food which gives your body all the nutrients it needs. You have to combine foods together, balance them out. And while I don't have time to give you a complete menu right now, I can give you a piece of healthy advice. Make sure you eat a rainbow of foods every day. If you want to keep your body feeling great, make sure that there's a rainbow on your mealtime plate. Now, I don't mean the kind of rainbow you see up in the sky. I mean a lot of different colored foods to please your eye. For instance, yellow corn, red tomatoes, pass the green beans, please. Blue grapes, oranges, dark bread, and light Swiss cheese. If you want to keep your body feeling great, make sure that there's a rainbow on your mealtime plate. It takes a lot of different foods to keep you strong, just like it takes a lot of different notes to make a song. Rainbow. Remember, it's up to you to take good care of yourself. Be good to your own good body, and it will be good to you.